Good evening, folks. Welcome to the loft at Hermit Woods. I'm Bob Manley. I'm one of the co-founders here at Hermit Woods. And just curious, how many of you are seeing a show here for the very first time? Fabulous. Lots of new folks in the room tonight. That's excellent. So before I get started, first of all, if I could ask all of you to please give a round of applause for Matt and the team in the kitchen and all the hardworking people putting the food on the table. And thank you, Matt. And how about a round of applause for Chris Miga, who put this stage together and is running sound tonight and going to make things beautiful for us. Thank you. Thank you, Chris. So I want to give you a little background. I'm one of the founders of Hermit Woods Winery. We started this business about 12 years ago. Hard to believe. It's pretty amazing. It's been a good run. And we started in my home. We started our winery in my master bedroom. Yep, absolutely true. And you're wondering, how did you get your wife to go along with that crazy idea? Well, I told her I'd fill her whole basement up with wine. Worked out perfectly. So we ran it out of my home for about 3 years, and in 2013, we grew out of our home, and we moved into Meredith here, one of the best decisions we could have ever made. It's a beautiful place, and we've been growing our business here ever since then. And sometime in the last few years, we used to use this space. This was sort of like an 80s law office when we bought this building, and we didn't really know what to do with it. It had some old carpet and some wallpaper and six cubicle offices with 6 foot, 7 foot ceilings, and so we didn't know what to do with it. So we'd use it for storage, and the winery used the rest of the space. And one day, I stuck my head into the attic, and I saw that the ceiling was a false ceiling. There was really ability to go way up, and I said, I know what we could do with this space. We need to make it into a music venue. And that didn't come out of nowhere. That came from the fact that about 10 years ago, back at the beginning of the winery, I had an opportunity to go see a show at a place called Pittman's Freight Room. I'm sure some of you have heard of it. It's a great venue in Laconia, and I met this guy, John Lorenz, who was putting on what he called a listening room series, something I had never heard of before. And I went to a show, and I was blown away. I got an opportunity to appreciate music and listen to performances in the way I've never really gotten a chance to do it before. And it really, it was an opportunity not just for me as an audience member to appreciate the music on stage, but it showed to me that it was really a great opportunity for the musicians to interact with the audience in a way that they might not be able to in a different type of setting. So I fell in love with the concept and went and saw as many shows as I could at that place. And sadly, eventually, that business went out and John wasn't able to continue it. But when I found this high ceiling here, I called up John and I said, John, we need to do this. We need to make another listening room. And got him excited about it, and over the last 5 years, John and I and my partners and a bunch of other very talented people helped put this space together. And we actually turned it into a listening room of our very own. We opened to the public for the very first time. Not that long ago, it was May of 22 is when we put on our first show. And we've been putting music on almost every week since then, and have had some absolutely amazing performances on this stage. I feel so fortunate to be able to be here every time. I get to see more music than I've ever seen in my life. And I'm so appreciative for all of you for taking the time to come out and see the show tonight and supporting live music and supporting our new venue here. And I promise you, as long as you folks will keep coming out, I will do this for the rest of my life. I am happy. I got wine downstairs. Thank you. What more could a guy ask for, right? So thank you all for supporting our venue and supporting live music. I want to give you a couple heads up, some shows coming up on December 15th and the 22nd. We don't just do live music here on off nights. We also do comedy. I don't know if anybody knows Justin McKinney, but he's an outstanding New Hampshire comic, and he's going to be performing on Friday. Friday show, I believe, is sold out. There might be one ticket or two tickets left, but he was gracious enough to offer us another night, so he will be back on the 22nd. So if you didn't get tickets for tonight's or Friday night's show, tomorrow night's show. Yeah, there are tickets for next week still. They'll go fast, though. I guarantee it'll sell out. He sells out 3,000-seat venues all over New England. So, Songwriter Roundup, if you have not heard of our Songwriter Roundup, it is a fantastic show. Katie Dobbins out of Guilford is the organizer of that show, and she brings very talented songwriters from all over New England to come to the stage and do a Nashville-style roundup. It's been a real joy to work with Katie and see the really wonderful music that she brings to this stage. She sells out almost every show, so if you're interested in a songwriter roundup show, get your tickets early because they do sell out. And then on the 28th, we have Randy Roos, the Hall of Mirrors show, another really outstanding performance. He's performed here before with all of the folks who will be on stage with him, and he puts on an amazing show. It's a little more avant-garde jazz. If you like that kind of music, he's got to be one of the best. It's mind-blowing. I really enjoy his experience. So those are some upcoming shows. Oh, we do have a New Year's Eve special. You can go on our website and learn about that. We're doing a New Year's Eve show. And I think that's enough. You didn't come here to hear me talk, I don't think, right? So we need to get some music going on in here. A couple things before that. It is a listening room, so we do ask you to remain quiet during the performance. And if you have a cell phone, you can, if you wouldn't mind, please turning it off or turn the ringer off so we don't have the cell phones ringing during the event. And you'll notice you have a little call button on your table. So if during the show, we make it as easy as possible for you to get your server's attention without having to speak loudly or, you know, raise your hand or whatever. You just push that button, and your server should come up over to your table and help you out. So, without further ado, I'm so proud and so pleased to bring, for the second time to this stage, the Vintage Vocal Quartet. They bring us big band era They bring big band era to life, singing while swinging on piano, guitar, bass, and trumpet. And so, let's bring to the stage with Paul. I'm not going to get this name right. Pampanella. Thank you. I'm terrible with names. Thank you. Welcome, Paul. Paul is on guitar and vocals. And Chris Humphrey, tenor, trombone, and drums. Welcome, Chris. And Taylor O'Donnell. She'll be on soprano and piano tonight. And of course, finally, David Scott, tenor and bass.
Did you twist out my bass strap, though?
That I did not.
This was not like this before.
That was the bar.
That's not right. That's not right. There we go.
Taylor.
Bass strap.
Yes, David.
Don't you just love the holidays? I feel like we should be doing a TV special from 1976. Keep playing. All right, it's working. Bob, thank you so much for having us back. We must not have acquitted ourselves too poorly last time we were here because we're able to come back. This is a kind of a special night, though, because we are going to welcome back for the first time after her maternity leave, Taylor O'Donnell, to the band.
I'm back. So wonderful to be here.
All right, does that thing work?
We're going to be doing some, like you said, some swing era music. We're also going to do a light dusting, if you will, of holiday favorites as well, because, you know,
a sprinkling.
Right? Okay, I'm glad to see some applause.
A sprinkling,
just a light dusting of holiday music, because, you know, nothing says the holidays like a nice, cozy listening room and some nice, cozy music. So, shall we?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire. Jack Frost nipping at your nose. Yuletide carols being sung by a choir. And folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows. Some turkey and some mistletoe help to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow
will find it hard to sleep tonight.
They know that Santa's on his way.
Ooh.
He loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. And every mother's child is gonna spy to see if a reindeer really know how to fly. I'm offering this simple phrase,
just this simple phrase,
to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you. Santa's on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. Every child will spy to see if reindeer really know. To 92.
Although it's been said many times, many ways.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you so much. I think the last time we performed that song was with the Cape Symphony in about maybe 5 years ago. But we asked Bob if we could bring them tonight, and he said, there's something about like the fire code or something like that. So Sorry, you just get us four. All right, we have another holiday song for you now with featuring Chris and Taylor.
I'm dreaming tonight of a place I love even more than I usually do, and although I know it's a long road back, I promise you I'll be home for Christmas. You can count on me. Please have snow and mistletoe. Was David's arrangement of I'll Be Home for Christmas that made Taylor and I sound so good.
That song always kind of gets me because there's that twist at the end, and I think I listened to this song for years and years before I caught the twist, right? I'll Be Home for Christmas, I was always thinking, well, you know, he sounds pretty confident, right? I will be home for Christmas, and I always kind of just let the rest of the lyrics wash over me until one day I realized, if only in my dreams. Oh, it's like my head went,
you know, oh, he's not going to be home for Christmas. That's what the whole song is about. That, I, yeah. It just, I, it took me a while, but I figured it out.
Wicked smart kid.
So nice to be back in New Hampshire. We don't have any New Hampshireites in the band, but we have two maniacs.
Mainers.
I grew up in Merrimack.
Oh, you did? Oh, okay, so you're in New Hampshire, right? All right.
Tomahawks, class of 83.
Nice. Okay, so
the high school's called the Tomahawks, but the middle school is called the Hatchets, which is really cool.
Wow. All right. Ooh, is that right? Is that okay?
Well, I'll give you a name, Merrimack, you know.
I mean, Molly Hatchet, or?
Yeah, I don't know.
Okay.
Sorry. All right. So we're going to do next for you something from the best-selling, basically the Taylor Swift of the 1940s. This is from the Glenn Miller Orchestra. And their vocal group, of course, was called the Modernaires. So we are the Modernaires, and, you know, I think Glenn Miller's band was it 15 pieces? 13? What, four rhythm? Five. Anyway, we don't. Again, you know, we couldn't bring the Cape Symphony. We couldn't bring the big band tonight. But we have a trombone, which
Chris
counts
Humphrey
for a lot.
Playing the trombone.
We have Chris Humphrey.
Yeah. Right.
That packs a punch.
It does. Yeah. All right. Shall we?
We shall.
All right. You got it.
Anyone else but me. No, don't sit under the apple tree with anyone else but me till I come marching home.
Don't go walking down Lover's Lane with anyone else but me.
Anyone else but me. No, don't go walking down Lover's Lane with anyone else but me till I come marching home.
I just got word from a guy who heard from the guy next door to me. The girl he met just loves to pet, and it fits you to a T.
So don't sit under the apple tree with anyone else but me till I come marching home.
Don't give out with those lips of yours with anyone else but me. To anyone else but me. Watch the girls on the foreign shore. You're getting the third degree when you come marching home. Don't hold anyone on your knee. You better be true to me. You better be true to me. You better be true to me. Don't hold anyone on your knee. You're getting the third degree when you come marching home. You're on your own where there is no phone, and I can't keep tabs on you. Be fair to me, I'll guarantee that's the one thing that I'll do. I won't sit under the apple tree with anyone else but you till you come marching home.
Don't sit under the apple tree with anyone else but me.
apple tree is reserved for you and me, and I'll be true till you come marching home. Yeah.
Who was the female singer on that track? Do you remember? I think, was it Tex Beneke as the guy?
Yes.
Tex, but I can't remember the girl. So he was Tex, and she was, anybody know?
The girl.
The girl.
The mysterious.
Who was it?
Could have been Helen O'Connell.
Maybe. Well, let's go with Helen O'Connell. Helen O'Connell, everybody.
Thank you.
So we're going to do a song. This was a Johnny Mercer tune. And Johnny was the rare, you know, everybody's heard of singer-songwriters, right? Like Bob was talking about the great singer-songwriter series that you got here at Herman Woods. But back in the day, there were no singer-songwriters. There were singers and there were songwriters, but there were very, very few and far between that somebody did both. But there were a few of them. Nat Cole was one, Peggy Lee was one, Hoagy Carmichael was one, and Johnny Mercer. So this one is from Johnny. Take you to church. I think. Gather round me, everybody. Gather round me while I preach some. I feel a sermon coming on me. The topic will be sin, and that's what I'm again. So if you want to hear my story, then settle back and just sit tight while I start reviewing the attitude of doing right. You've got to accent accentuate the positive, eliminate the negative, latch on to the affirmative, don't mess with Mr. In-Between. You gotta spread joy up to the maximum, bring gloom down to the minimum, have faith or pandemonium is liable to walk upon the scene. To illustrate that last remark,
Jonah in the whale, Noah in the ark.
What did they do just when everything looked so dark?
Man, they said we better accentuate the positive, eliminate the negative, and latch on to the affirmative.
Don't mess with Mr. In Between. No, don't mess with Mr. In Between.
You gotta spread joy up to the maximum, bring gloom down to the minimum, and have faith or pandemonium's liable to walk upon the scene.
You gotta accentuate the positive, eliminate the negative, latch on to the affirmative, don't mess with Mr. In Between.
No, don't mess with Mr. In Between.
Johnny loved to sing with this great vocal group, and they were with the Dorsey band, the Tommy Dorsey band. They were called the Pied Pipers, and this was one of their famous songs. Actually, don't you have a Dorsey connection?
A little bit. Yeah.
So Pampanella. It's a jazz name, right? You've heard that one before, but you're just not quite sure where. Pampanella. That's.
This jacket was worn on stage with the Jimmy Dorsey band. My uncle was a trombone player and an arranger, and that's kind of why I wear this thing. So there it is. There's my Dorsey connection.
Did he wear it in? Was this after Tommy and Jimmy broke up?
After the split. Yep, he was with them before, and then there were too many fistfights between Tommy and Jimmy, the Dorsey brothers, mm-hmm. and so then he just by chance went with Jimmy.
I thought trashing hotel rooms and fighting among members of the band didn't start until hair metal in the 80s.
It started with the Dorsey brothers. Right. They were original sinners.
What I want to know is there any Dorsey blood on that coat?
I'm hoping not.
All right, this is from the Pied Pipers with the Dorsey band. And featuring Taylor as Jo Stafford, the fabulous.
Some big shoes.
Woo!
Dream when you're feeling blue. Dream, that's the thing to do. Dream while the smoke rise in the air, you'll find your share of memories there. So dream when the day is through. Dream.
That's Chris as Tommy Dorsey, everyone. All right, so we do a lot of big band music in this band. We also like the smaller groups, and about as small a group as you can get is the Nat Cole Trio. And an interesting story behind how they got started. Nat Cole was on a national touring show, and he was from Chicago, and he got to L.A., Long Beach specifically, and the treasurer of the play that he was in, left. He skipped town. He took all the money and left. So there was a 15-piece orchestra, 10 singers, 20 dancers, all stuck in L.A. And Nat looked around and said, why would I want to go back to Chicago anyway? And he decided that he wanted to get a big band sound with the smallest possible package. So that was when he founded the Nat Cole Trio. So we're going to do some Nat Cole Trio for you.
I like to riff. I like to riff. Riffing is the thing for me. I like to riff. I like to riff.
Oh, it's a solid killer. Riffing is the thing for me.
If you want to be a sender, knock your friends and do a bender. Grab a major scale and run it.
Zip.
I like to riff.
Cause it makes you feel so fine.
I like to riff.
Takes your troubles off your mind. Riffing is the thing for me. Well, you can riff like this. Riff like this. Cause it makes you feel so fine.
I like to riff.
Get your troubles off your mind. Zip.
Favorite tune from that band, if other than that one, might be Straighten Up and Fly Right.
Yeah,
I think we
sure.
should. We should probably
oh, yeah. should add that one. Get on that yeah. next time.
Buzzer took the monkey for a ride in the air. The monkey thought that everything was on the square. The buzzard tried to throw the monkey off his back, but the buzzard.
Listen, Jack.
Cracked his neck. The buzzard turned his neck and said, "Now listen, Jack. Straighten up and fly right."
Yeah. Yeah. We're gonna improvise this new composition.
Well, this next one is one of my favorite Nat King Cole Trio. My first songs that introduced me to the Nat King Trio, the bassless quartet that he had. And this particular arrangement I heard done by Diana Krall. It's with Jeff Hamilton on drums. It's fantastic. So I hope you enjoy.
Oh, great. This. Tommy Dorsey and now Glenn Miller.
Okay, here we go. I want two, three.
I love Diana Krall's version, but I like yours better.
You want to choose the next one?
Sure. The next tune we're going to do is a little bit later, the 1950s. This one is Miles Davis recorded this in 1954, and John Hendricks wrote lyrics to Miles's trumpet solo. And then he also wrote lyrics to Horace Silver's piano solo. So I'm going to be Miles Davis. David's going to be Horace Silver. And I'm not playing the trumpet, and he's not playing the piano. So. These are John Hendricks' beautiful lyrics to this tune called Four. And it's kind of cool when you have to write lyrics to a tune and all you have is the title. So what are you going to write about when the song is just called Four?
Well, and I don't know, does anybody have Chris's album of Clark Terry songs? It's great. I highly recommend you picking it up. Just this, did that come out this year?
Yeah, last year.
Yeah, so great drummer and lyricist Les Harris Jr. wrote a bunch of lyrics to a bunch of classic Clark Terry trumpet songs, compositions, and solos. And
volume two is coming out very soon.
So you released volume one this past year, and volume two is coming out.
Volume two is coming out.
It's highly recommended.
Of the wonderful things that you get out of life, there are four. Maybe, and there may not be many, but nobody needs any more.
Of the many facts making the list of life, truth takes the lead. And to relax, knowing the gist of life, it's truth you need.
And the second is honor, and happiness makes number three. When you put them together, you'll know what the last one must be.
Babies are the truth, honor and happiness. and one thing more, meaning only wonderful, wonderful love that will make it far. Don't you know the score? Well, people when they're younger never realize the pleasure treasure life's got. But as they grow older, they realize a lot. They got their minds on all the wrongest scenes and things that cost a lot of money. Well, it's really very funny. They fade away and don't amount to a hill of beans. Funny how the things in life we really should adore, we forget or ignore, end up poor. Making money till you're nigh unto madness and end up in sadness. Youth is the time when we should see the light. But use for what we wasted, use for what we painted one so high that we fade and we die. Then we know that youth that made us strong is wasted on the young. So enjoy it gaily, love life, and live it daily. You'll find a lot of things to bring you joy and give peace of mind. Get it while the getting's good. And everybody, if they only should, you know that life would be a set. Life would be a groovy set, groovy as a movie. Well, well, let your voice be heard, spread the word. Everybody here's got ears, only gotta teach them how to use them, not abuse them. So take a tip from me, the world's everything it ought to be, as long as you can be sure there is no more to life than the same old four.
Hard to believe, I know, but time will show that even though you find it boresome, two and two together constitute a foursome. That's all, four is the figure. That's all, ain't gonna be getting any bigger. It doesn't matter how you slice it up, you'll never change it. You count everything that fate throws into life's pot, still, really four is all you've got. Haven't I told you about the little treasures that are part of all the rest? You love a little and live a little and give a little and take a lot, still the total is happiness. But that's only one, you've just begun. There's gonna be more, meaning only truth and honor shining and love combining to make it four. No more
of the wonderful things that you get out of life. There are four, baby, and there may not be many, but nobody needs any more of the many facts making the list of life. It's truth you need, and to relax, knowing the gist of life. Truth takes the lead, and the second is honor and happiness makes number three. When you put them together, you'll know what the last one must be. Baby, so the truth, honor and happiness, and one thing more, meaning only wonderful, wonderful love that'll make it far. And there ain't no more.
I'm really happy that the Christmas tree is here, because last time we played here, the piano was way over there. We had to sort of shout to be heard. But this time, we're nice and close. You gonna make it?
Yep. Am I gonna make it? This is definitely the better way to go.
Nice. All right, we're gonna do a song by one of the great. It's not, I wouldn't say they're a jazz group, would you? Like super early R&B, kind of like post Mills Brothers, but pre like Flamingos and all those kinds of groups. With the lead singer named Bill Kenny, with the absolutely beautiful falsetto. I understand some of my like teenage and college age students have been recognizing some of the songs by the Ink Spots, because I think they've been starting to put the songs in video games. Wow. Yeah.
That's random.
Yeah, I know. There's like some game that's like super violent and it features an Ink Spot song.
Blood spots?
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe it's like the irony of the...
I know that song. That's from Bloody Warfare.
Yeah, exactly.
And the riff to this song is iconic insofar as there's probably a half a dozen Ink Spot songs that start like this. So here's one of them.
Oh, but this one doesn't have the bass solo. The Ink Spots was also really famous for the second time through the chorus, after Bill Kenny would sing this high falsetto thing, the next chorus would be, "Baby, you know I love you."
The Barry White solo.
Yeah. And he would basically say the same lyrics that was just sung in the first verse, but he would talk it in a really low and sexy voice. We should add that to this too.
Perhaps.
I love coffee, I love tea. I love the Java Jive and it loves me. Coffee and tea and the Java and me. A cup, a cup, a cup, a cup, a cup. Ah, I love Java, sweet and hot. Whoops, Mr. Moto, I'm a coffee pot. Shoot me the pot and I'll pour me a shot. A cup, a cup, a cup, a cup, a cup. Oh, slip me a slug from that wonderful mug, and I'll cut a rug till I'm snug in a jug. A slash of onion and a raw one, draw one. Waiter, waiter, percolator, I love coffee, I love tea. I love the Java Jive and it loves me. Coffee and tea and the Java and me. A cup, a cup, a cup, a cup, a cup. Oh, Boston bean.
Soybeans,
yeah.
Green beans, cabbage and greens.
Now I'm not keen about a bean,
unless it is a cheery, cheery bean, boy.
Now I love coffee, I love tea, I love the Java Java, it loves me. Coffee and tea, the Java and me. A cup, a cup, a cup, a cup, a cup. Well, I love coffee, Java, sweet and hot. Whoops, Mr. Moto, I'm a coffee pot. Shoot me the pot and I'll pour me a shot. A cup, a cup, a cup, yeah. So throw me a slug from that wonderful mug, and I'll cut a rug till I'm snug in a jug. Go on and drop a nickel in the pot, Joe. Take 'em a slow. Waiter, waiter, perk. Later, I love coffee, I love tea, I love the Java Jive and it loves me. Coffee and tea and the Java and me.
Yeah!
A cup, a cup, a cup, a cup.
I grew up in New Jersey, not far from where Frank Sinatra grew up. He grew up, born and raised in Hoboken, New Jersey. And I grew up about, I don't know, 10 miles west of that. I could still see New York City from where I was.
Sometimes you say New Jersey and people start clapping, but I guess it's not that kind of a crowd.
I often say, yeah, I'm from New Jersey, but please don't hold it against me. But it was nice growing up in the shadow of New York. It was also nice to get out of the shadow of New York because not a clean place back in the 70s and 80s, and not that much cleaner now. So nice place to visit. Wouldn't want to live there. But I still appreciate the fact that I'm a Jersey guy like Frank Sinatra. Oh. And song and similarly named album In the Wee Small Hours of the Morning has the distinction of being by most music critics the first themed album, meaning that it was all about the whole album. It wasn't just song after song after song. It was all songs about heartbreak and sadness and things like that. So here's the title track from that song, from that album.
I recommend it to listen to that whole album in one sitting.
No, because
the Surgeon General has advised me.
Frank often stayed up until the wee small hours of the morning, commonly going to sleep at 7 a.m. after, torturing some guest or three to death with glasses of bourbon and stories upon stories. Not in Hoboken, though. Anyway. Here we are, wee small hours of the morning. In the small hours of the morning, while the whole wide world is fast asleep, you lie awake and think about the girl and never ever think of counting sheep. When your lonely has learned its lesson, you'd be hers if only she would call. In the wee small hours of the morning, that's the time you miss her most of all. Lesson, you'd be hers if only she would call. In the wee small hours of the morning, that's the time you miss her most of.
That's pretty right there. I don't care who you are.
we're going to get back into a little holiday spirit. You know, when people say they're doing seasonal music, they're always talking about the season they're in, right? I always thought about that because it'd be kind of a weird flex if you just said, okay, folks, tonight we're going to do a lot of seasonal music. Spring can really hang you up the most. The summer knows. Autumn leaves. I don't think people would like that too much. This is an original song. I actually wrote this on a really slushy drive through southern Iowa. The rhythm is exactly the rhythm of my windshield wipers. One thing is not recommended, writing songs while driving. I did get home safely, however, in time to write down this song. Sort of more of a hopeful thing because I've been driving through the slush. But here in New Hampshire, I think you'll know what I'm talking about. When you see a Christmas tree or hear that north wind blow, set a spell, cause you can tell that soon it's gonna snow. Me oh my, you just gotta try to catch old winter's show. Frosty air is everywhere and soon it's gonna snow. Walk down the lane when white is on your window pane. You'd better wear warm clothes when Jack Frost is nipping at your nose. So keep it warm, enjoy the storm, but drink that eggnog slow. Sing a song, it won't be long till we're all laying low. Soon it's gonna snow. Lin-lin, ba-da-ba-da-lay, ba-da-lay-lay-oh. Ba-yo-ba-way-lay-lay-lay. When you see that Christmas tree or hear that north wind blow, just sit a spell, cause you can tell that soon it's gonna snow. Me, oh my, you just gotta try to catch old winter's show. Frosty air is everywhere, and soon it's gonna snow. Oh, walk down the lane when white is on your window pane. You'd better wear warm clothes when Jack Frost is nipping at your nose. So keep it warm, enjoy the storm, but drink that eggnog slow. Sing a song, it won't be long till we're all laying low. Soon it's gonna snow, soon it's gonna snow. White stuff will fall around everywhere. Ice cubes will form right in your hair. Bring your long underwear, it's gonna snow. It's gonna snow. Killer snow, killer snow. Soon, soon it's gonna snow. Soon it's gonna snow. remembered the Brazilian singer.
Oh,
she
yes.
Was, she, when she does that thing with the piano and singing at the same time, I was like, it reminds me of some Brazilian singer, and I couldn't remember what. It's not. It's like, actually two. It's Jobim playing with Elis Regina. So she's singing and he's playing. So you are.
It's a very nice compliment. Thank you.
Two for the price of one.
All right, we're going to feature Paul on this next one.
All right, then. I've got to get my Bing Crosby on. All right, then.
Where's your pipe and your fedora?
Left him at home.
You're a better dad.
Okay.
We're speaking out.
Who loves the Bing Crosby Christmas stuff? I mean, right? Yeah, that's great. I was Taylor actually showed me this song yesterday that it's one of the lesser known Bing Christmas songs, and she's like, you know, listen to this. And I said, yeah, and played it. She said, doesn't he sound a little drunk? And I was like, I will never hear this song the same way again.
The sun is shining, the grass is green, the orange and palm trees sway. There's never been such a day in Beverly Hills, LA. But it's December the 24th, and I am longing to be up north,
like Meredith, New Hampshire.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know, where the treetops glisten and children listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, with every Christmas card I write, may your days be merry and bright.
I think you all know the words to this one, right?
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know. The treetops glisten. And may all your
give yourselves a hand.
It'd be the first ever Vintage Vocal Quartet sing-along. Good job.
I saw some people mouthing the words when we were doing Don't Sit Under the Apple Tree.
Wow, okay.
Does that count?
Yeah, almost. Almost.
Mouth along.
Yes.
Christmas makes you feel emotional. It can bring parties or thoughts devotional. But whatever happens or what may be, this is what Christmas time means to me. One, two, three, one, two. City sidewalks, busy sidewalks, dressed in holiday style. In the air, there's a feeling of Christmas. See your children laughing, children passing, eating smile. Thank you for the help after smile. And on every street corner, you hear silver bells, it's Christmas time in the city. Hear them ring, soon it will be Christmas Day. Silver bells, it's Christmas time in the city. Hear them ring, jingling. Soon it will be Christmas Day. Strings of streetlights, even stoplights, blink a bright red and green as the shoppers come home with their treasures. Hear the snow crunch, see those kids bunch. This is Santa's big scene. And above all that bustle, you hear silver bells, it's Christmas time in the city. Hear them ring, jingling. Soon it's Christmas Day. Oh, silver bells. Oh, silver bells. Oh, it's Christmas time in the city. Oh. Thank you so much. Got a little help. A little bit more backbeat.
More than usual.
Mm-hmm. Paul, you got the next one, right?
I do.
All right. Sort of a love song, right?
Kind of sort
of. Unrequited?
Yep, as they all are.
Yeah, most of them. All the good ones, anyway.
Small hours of the morning. Mm-hmm. It's right up in there.
maybe just baritones never get the girl, and so that's why all their songs are
sad. Oh, no. That's not, that is, no. Married for 29 years, okay. I got one.
Only takes one.
In most cultures, yes. That is true. Little tune inspired, old song, maybe the oldest song in our set by the date of its composition. Little version inspired by John Pizzarelli. If you know who that is, he's a guitarist, singer, famous for that Foxwoods commercial.
Right.
Foxwoods,
see you at Foxwoods.
The wonder of it all.
That's it, the wonder of it all.
Yeah. I just remember the last bit. See you at Foxwoods. Thank you. I'm confessing.
Don't think twice, take our advice. Confessing is the way to go.
I'm confessing that I love you. Tell me, do you love me too? I'm confessing that I need you. Honest, I do. Need you every moment. In your eyes I read such strange things, but your lips deny they're true. Will your answer really change things, making me blue? I'm afraid someday you'll leave me, saying, can't we still be friends? If you go, you know you grieve me. All in life on you depends. Am I guessing that you love me? Dreaming dreams of you in vain. I'm confessing that I love you over again.
Don't quit now, we'll show you how. Confessing is the way to go.
Next song is Irving Berlin. It's from the movie White Christmas. And this is one of the just goofiest Christmas songs there are. I think, Paul, you didn't like this when we first...
Hated it.
Yeah.
Hated it.
How do you feel about it now?
I love it. Oh my goodness, it's so good.
So why did you hate it and why do you love it?
Because, okay, hated it because it made no sense. Mm-hmm. It made no sense. It just random, oh, here's a melody, here's a different key, here's, oh, now we're going back to the other key, and everybody's just singing randomly. And now I love it because it makes no sense. And changing keys and singing person to person randomly.
Chris, you said you just saw the scene today, right?
I just went back and watched the scene on YouTube from the movie, and it's so great because they're excited for snow. They haven't seen snow, and it's Christmas is coming, and they're excited for snow, and they're really excited for snow, and they keep talking about how, hey, guys, soon we're going to see snow. So count the snows in the song. There's many of them.
Well, and who's in it? Who's in the scene?
Rosemary Clooney.
Bing
Crosby, Danny Kaye.
Danny Kaye.
Mm-hmm.
And Vera somebody. Right?
Vera Ellen.
But Vera Ellen isn't, she's over, her voice is overdubbed with somebody else, right?
Yes.
Vera Ellen's an actress, but
that must have been a hard time keeping up with them. So.
What's that?
We forgive her.
Yeah, oh yeah. I mean, showbiz.
Yeah.
It's like, oh no, her voice is overdubbed.
Yeah. And
it's showbiz.
Been done for 100 years.
Can get through this one?
Yes.
This song is a jigsaw puzzle.
I love it.
If all the pieces come together, then you have a completed puzzle.
Makes no sense.
And if I mess up like I did last time, then you don't.
Makes no sense.
So let's see what happens. One, two, ready, go.
It won't be long until we'll be met with snow.
Snow. I wanna wash my hands, my face and hair with snow.
Snow, I long to clear a path and lift a spade of snow.
Snow. To see a great big man entirely made of snow.
Snow, where it's snowing all winter through, that's where I want to be.
Snowball throwing, that's what I'll do. How I'm longing to see
through the snow. Those glistening houses that seem to be made of snow.
Snow, snow, to see a mountain covered with a
what is Christmas with no snow? No white Christmas with no snow.
I'll soon be there with snow. I'll wash my hair with snow.
And with a spade of snow, I'll build a man that's made of snow. I'd love to stay up with you, but I think a good shut I go to sleep and dream of snow.
So we learned that one especially for you in hopes that you'll tell Bob to bring us back another time because we always have something new for you guys. All right, we got a couple more songs. It's been a great evening. Thank you so much to Bob for bringing us and Chris on the sound. We got two more tunes for you and then we will bid you adieu. Here we go. This is the Boswell Sisters. I'm gonna sit right down and write myself a letter. This is from Fats Waller. For fans of the radio show Marketplace, this is the song they play when they're doing reader mail.
Wow, okay, great.
Beep, boop, beep, boop, beep, beep, beep. A one, two, a one, two, three, four.
Mailman passes by, I just wonder why. He never stops to ring my front door bell.
single line to that old love of mine. Not a word since I last heard farewell. That's the reason that I'm gonna sit right down and write myself a letter. Make believe it came from you. I'm gonna write words oh so sweet. They're gonna knock me off my feet.
A lot of kisses on the bottom. I'll be oh so glad I got them.
I'm gonna smile and say I hope you're feeling better. Close with love the way you used to do. Oh, I'm gonna sit right down and write myself a letter. Make believe, make believe, make believe the letter came from you.
I'm gonna sit right down and write myself a letter. Kisses on the bottom. I'll be glad that I got them. I'm gonna smile and say I hope you're feeling better. And close with love the way you used to do. I'm gonna sit right down and write myself a letter. Whoa. And make believe it came from you, just you. Whoa.
Thanks again. Thanks, Bob. Everybody, let's hear it for Bob. One of the hardest things to do in music, harder than playing the bass or the piano or singing, is creating a musical scene. And Bob is trying his darndest to do that. So let's support Bob and Hermit Woods. One more time, just introducing the members of the band. On guitar, we have Paul Pampanella. This thing is not a mandolin. I've been asked. This is a bass. And my name is David Scott. Playing drums, singing tenor, playing trombone. We should get you on kazoo one of these days. This is Chris, the singular, Chris Humphrey. And the leading light of the band on the piano, singing soprano, Taylor O'Donnell, everybody.
I'm so tired of this dull routine. Up the town on the 8:15. Back at night, off to bed, and then get up and start it all over again.
Let's take a boat to Bermuda. Let's take a plane to St. Paul. Let's take a kayak to Quincy or Nyack. Let's get away from it all. Let's take a trip in a trailer. No need to come back at all. Let's take a powder to Boston for chowder. Let's get away from it all. We'll travel round from town.
leave our hut, dear, get out of our rut, dear. Let's get away from it all. Hit the road and really get away from it all.
Catch a tuna out in Laguna.
Let's get away from it all.
Let's travel south of the border. I'll get a real shawl
for me a muchacha.
But not while I watch it.
Let's get away from it all.
They say there's no place quite like home. A charming thought and pure.
But until the world we roam, how can we be sure?
Let's spend a weekend in Southland. I'll get a real southern drum.
Then off to Reno.
Nah, just a play, you know.
Let's get away from it all.
The 48.
Off to Niagara. This time we're digging the fall. Yes, we're leaving. We're hitting the road. Oh, we're leaving. We're hitting the road. Yes, we're leaving. We're hitting the road. Oh, we're getting away from it all.
Thank you, everybody.
Do, 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 do.